Hi students, today we are going to discuss about principles of metallurgy. Coming to properties of metals, first one is hard and high melting point and boiling points. That means metals are hard to touch, they have high melting point. That means they melt at very high temperature, and high boiling point, they boil at very high temperatures. Good conductors of heat and electricity. Metals can pass heat and electricity through them. Suppose, for example, if we heat any metal rod, we will get that heatness to the other side also. That means they are allowing to pass heat to pass through them. Metals are malleable. Malleable means they can be made into thin sheets. Suppose, for example, we are making thin iron sheets, thin zinc sheets for various purposes. So this process of metals is called malleability. And ductile. Ductile means they can be made into thin wires. We are making gold wire, silver wire, copper wires, iron wires, etc. So this property of metal is called ductile property. Next, metals are lustrous in nature. Lustrous means they have shining property. They can shine. That property of metals is called lustrous. And last one is sonorous. Sonorous means metals can give sound. For example, we are using iron bells. Why can't we use wooden bells? Because metals will give sound. So these are some physical properties of metals. Occurrence of metals. How do we get metals? First one is, earth crust is the major source of metals. Earth crust, that means we are getting metals from the earth. And some metals like sodium and potassium we are getting from seawater. Most of the metals are not available in native state in the earth crust due to high reactivity. This is very important. We are not getting metal as metal form from the earth. We are getting as a combined substance because they have high reactivity. They can react with other substances, so it is available in combined form. But some metals like copper, silver, gold and platinum available in free state or native state due to less reactivity. That means they cannot react with other substances very easily. So we are getting those in free state. These metals are called noble metals. Basing upon this reactivity, we are dividing metals into three series. First one, highly reactive. Second one, moderate reactive. Third one, less reactive. Highly reactive means they can react with other substances very easily. Moderate means only one or two substances they can react with, like oxygen, oxides, sulfur, sulfides, carbon, carbonates, like that. Less reactive. Less reactive means they will not react with other metals easily. Example, gold and silver. Aluminium is the third most abundant element and most abundant metal in the earth crust. They will ask question like this: what is the most abundant metal in earth crust? That is aluminium. Okay. Many metals are available in the form of oxides and sulfides. That means metals we are getting in form of oxides. That means they are mixing with oxygen and available in nature. Or they are mixing with sulfur and available in nature. 16th group elements like oxygen and sulfur are called chalcogens, because metals are reacting with the oxygen and sulfur more. So those elements are called as chalcogens. 16th group elements all are called as chalcogens. Important terms of metallurgy. Metallurgy. What is metallurgy? The process of extraction of metal from naturally occurring compounds is called metallurgy. We are getting metal in combined form from the earth, but we are following some methods to extract pure metal. This process is all under metallurgy. Okay, this process is called metallurgy. Mineral. The natural substance in which metal occurs either in native state or combined state is called mineral. That means what we are getting from the earth to extract metal is called mineral. whether it may be in native state or in the combined state, no matter. But what we are getting from earth, that is called mineral. If the mineral is, or the mineral which from which metals are extracted economically and conveniently are called ores. That means we are getting so many minerals, but by using some minerals we can get the metal very easily with less economic and very convenient methods. So those minerals are called ores. That means for iron so many minerals are there, but only one ore will be there, because from that ore we will get iron in the best way, in the easy way, with very less cost. Okay, those are called ores. So a metal have more than one mineral, but only one ore. Next, gang. Gang means we learned that mineral have so many impurities. That impurity is called gang. Flux, a substance that added to mineral to remove the gang. To remove the gang impurity, we are adding some substances to the mineral. That substance is called flux. Flux are two types, acidic flux, basic flux. Depending upon the nature of the gang, we will add acidic flux or basic flux. Suppose the impurity is acidic in nature, we will add basic flux. Suppose the impurity is basic in nature, we will add acidic flux. Okay. Next is slag. When we are adding flux to the gang, we will get a chemical substance. That substance is called slag. See, give an example to SiO2 plus FeO gives rise to FeSiO3. From flux we are adding gang, we are getting slag. Extraction of metals from the ores. How we get metals from the ores in three states? Those are in three states. First one is concentration or dressing of ore, extraction of crude metal, refining or purification of metal. So in these three methods we are following metal, we are making metals. First one, concentration of ore. Removal or getting rid of gang from ore as much as possible is called concentration of ore. By using some methods, so much percent of impurity we can remove by using physical and chemical methods. That method is called concentration of ore. Some methods are hand picking. See how we hand pick the stones from the rice. In the same way, some impurities of metals can be hand picked. Those are different in size, shape and color. And next one, hydraulic washing. By washing with water we can remove some impurities. And gravity, suppose we are getting butter from buttermilk by using gravitational force. In the same way we can remove impurities also. Next, froth flotation. Froth flotation means to the mineral we are adding pine oil and we are giving pressure. With the pressure the impurities will float in the liquid. In the oil the impurities will float. By using filtration method easily we can remove those impurities. This is one method. And next one is magnetic separation. Magnetic separation, this method is based on difference in magnetic properties. Suppose ore is normal substance and gang, which is the impurity, it has magnetic property. Then if we use a magnet, the gang will attracted by the magnet, so we can separate them. Okay, these are methods. Next one, leaching. Leaching means by using a chemical compound we can remove some impurities. So this method, using chemical substance we can remove impurity. This method is called leaching. Extraction of crude metal from the purified ore. So above four methods are used to remove the impurities. Now we are extracting metal. For this one, first of all we have to understand the series. Already we understood highly reactive, moderate reactive and low reactive. Depending upon this reactivity series, we can use different types of methods, because some are highly reactive, so we have to follow some types of methods. Some are moderate reactives, we have to follow different types of methods. We can't follow common methods to all the metals, okay? See, more reactive metals like sodium, potassium, etc. are not prepared by ore chemical reaction with normal reducing agents. They require high temperature and more expensive. So, to get highly reactive metals, we have to use more temperature and very expensive. And what are more reactive metals obtained by electrolytic reduction of their molten or fused compounds? That means we have to use high temperature to molten them. We have to first of all change them into liquid state, then only we can separate the impurities. And electrolysis is a simple method. For example, we learned already electrolysis of water, that is simple one, but we can't use this electrolysis process to the highly reactive metals, okay? Next, extraction of metals in the middle of the activity. Some are moderate active, we learned, like zinc, iron. Those we have to follow some more methods like roasting. Roasting means we have to heat the ore in presence of oxygen. When we heat the in presence of oxygen, the impurities will combine with oxygen and form as gas. Suppose copper sulfur impurity is there in zinc sulfide, ZnS. If we heat with oxygen, sulfur and oxygen will form as sulfur dioxide gas, and we will get the zinc in the metal form. Okay, so these are some methods. Next one, smelting. Smelting means heating ore. This is also heating ore, but we have to follow some more method. Here we are adding flux to the gong. Blast furnace is used to smelting process. In the preparation of iron smelting process, coke and limestone are added to the ore. Some substances we are adding to the ore and we are heating. By heating like that, coke and limestone, we can remove the impurities from the iron. Okay, so this process can be done in blast furnace, okay, because we need very high temperature to burn the iron. Next, reduction of oxides into the metals. Metal oxides are reduced to metals by using reducing agent. Reducing agent means, reduction means we have to remove the oxygen. Suppose PbO plus C. Here oxygen is the impurity. So to remove the impurity, we are adding carbon. So carbon and oxygen, carbon monoxide, it will come under gas form. So we will get Pb, lead. So by using this reduction method also, we can purify the metals. Next, reduction of more reactive metal displaces less reactive metals from other ores. In this thermal process, aluminium is used as reducing agent and heat liberated to keep the metal in molten state. This process is used in welding of railway tracks. Reduction by more reactive metals. See the example, aluminium plus iron oxide. Here we are displacing the oxygen. Here actually Fe is having oxygen. After reaction, aluminium is getting oxygen and Fe can be separated. But still here very high temperature we are using, that means it will be in liquid state. This liquid state iron is used to repair the damages in the railway track. Okay, extraction of metals at the bottom of activity series. Bottom means very less active metals like gold, silver, mercury, etc. These can be used by using simple methods like oxidation and reduction. We can purify these metals. See, 2HgO gives rise to 2Hg plus O2. Just we are heating. When we are heating, oxygen will be removed. Okay. In this way, we can get pure metals. Next, purification. How to purify the extracted metal? For this also we are following so many methods. First one is distillation. Distillation means when metals have metal and impurity have different boiling points, we can use this distillation method. Okay. Next, liquation. This method is used for low melting metals and high melting impurities. Next, poling. Poling method is used for metals containing metal oxides, because in this process we will use molten metal and we will mix it with the wooden poles. With wooden poles, when you will mix like this, the impurity gas removed in the form of slag. Okay. Next, cupellation. Cupellation means this method used for metals containing easily oxidizable impurities like silver. Easily oxidizable, that means silver can be easily oxidizable. Okay, for this type of methods, these type of metals, we will use this method. That means suppose silver oxide, if we will add some carbon and oxygen will be removed as gas and we will get the pure silver. Next, electrolyte refining means when we are using electrolysis method, the pure metal will deposit at cathode and the impurities will deposit at anode part. So at cathode we are getting metal and at anode we are getting impurities as a mud. So easily we can remove this impurities. And next topic is corrosion. Corrosion means damage to the metal. How we are getting damage to the metal? Suppose if we will take example of iron, if we will keep an iron gate without paint, after some time we can observe the rust of iron. How we are getting this rust? This rust is due to water and air in the atmosphere. Due to water and air in the atmosphere, we are getting this rust. Okay, that means during corrosion process, metal act as anode, undergoes oxidation. That means these metals are reacting with oxygen and absorbing oxygen. So this is a oxidation reaction. Corrosion of iron is called rusting. Iron corrosion is called rusting. Rusting of iron occurs in presence of water, moisture and air. Okay, that means already I explained, actually iron is there, if water and air, oxygen are added, they form as a rust. Refining of metal, already this refining metal already I explained, we are going to thermite process. The amount of heat evolved is so large that the metal produced in molten state. This type of reaction is called thermite process. When we are heating metal, a very high temperature heat can be evolved. This process is called thermite process. Suppose example Fe2O3 plus 2Al gives rise to 2Fe plus Al2O3 plus heat. Already I explained this process we are using in repairing railway tracks. Okay, because at that high temperature iron will be in a liquid state. When we are keeping in the cracks liquid iron, after some time when the temperature decreases, it becomes hard. So in this way we can use this molten iron to repair cracks in railway tracks and machines. Furnace is one which is used to carry out pyrochemical process is called metallurgy. That means we already learned so many processes to get a purified metal, but to do all these reactions in one place, we need a special equipment called furnace. In this furnace, some types are there. First one is reverberatory furnace. In reverberatory furnace, we can do both calcination and roasting in one place only. In open hearth furnace, we have to generate heat. We have to burn the fuel and we have to generate heat. blast furnace smelting can be carried out. Smelting can be carried out. That means we can add some chemical substances to remove the impurities. See, all the chemical reactions are given below. Once practice them. Next, hydrometallurgy. The method which is based on fact that more electropositive metals displace less electropositive metals from the salt solution is called hydrometallurgy. That means this process can be used for metals which have more electropositive, and metals with less electropositive can be used by using hydrometallurgy. Once remember this one. That means suppose electropositive metals displaces hydrometallurgy, the method which is based on fact that more electropositive metals displace less electropositive metals from their salt solution. That means so many metals are there in salt solution, but one can displace other due to its electropositive nature. This process is called hydrometallurgy. Next, read the table thoroughly. They will ask ore or metal or formula. Anything can be asked. Ask oxide ores, carbonate ores, sulfide ores, sulfate ores and halide ores. Okay, they can use anything. Suppose, what is the formula of Hahn silver? AgCl. What metal we are getting from the Hahn silver? Silver. Okay, like that we can read. Next, alloys. What are alloys? Metals have some properties like corrosion. So to avoid these problems, what we are doing, we are mixing one or two metals or more than three metals to make them strong, to make them, to protect them from the corrosion. Those are called alloys. Suppose stainless steel, we are using as utensils in cooking, for cooking, and so many surgical items also we are making with stainless steel. This stainless steel is made with iron, chromium and nickel. They will ask the questions, what are the metals in stainless steel? Iron, chromium, nickel. And some are used to musical instruments also, like brass. See, copper and zinc. Only copper can't do this one. When you add zinc, they can be more strong. And nichrome, very important one. Nichrome means nickel, iron, chromium, manganese. This nichrome is used as heating element. Heating element means like iron box. When you give the electricity, it will get heatness. Okay, those are made with nichrome. Okay, they will ask anything. What are the metals in the bronze, copper and tin? Okay, once read this one. Okay, okay, thank you students, all the best for your IIIT exam. Thank you so much.